BlocksCAD Skills, The Rotate Transform, Part 1, Rotating Shapes in BlocksCAD. In this video, we're going to learn how to rotate shapes. To get started, let's drag out a cube from the 3D Shapes tab and drop it onto our workspace. Before we render it, let's change the default cube parameters. Let's set it to 2 wide in the X direction, 6 wide in the Y direction, and 12 high in the Z direction. This will make it easier to see the rotation. Now hit render. Because a rotation is a kind of transformation, we'll find the rotation block under the Transforms tab in the Blocks category menu on the left side of the screen. Drag it out and snap it into place around the cube block. You can rotate any shape around the X, Y, or Z axes. We'll start by changing the parameter of the X axis. Notice how rotation in BlocksCAD is indicated in degrees. And we can make changes by simply turning the pointer or needle in the angle window. You can drag around the rotation needle to whatever value you want. Let's see what happens if we set a rotation on the x-axis to 45 degrees. Hit render. Alternatively, you can type the number in directly. Let's type 60 degrees, hit enter to set the value, and then render. Now our shape is rotated 60 degrees on the x-axis. Let's reset the x-axis to 0, or no rotation, and see what happens when we change the value on the y-axis. Let's change the y value to 45 degrees and hit render. Can you see what just happened? Stop and replay this section of the video if you'd like to see it again. Okay, let's reset the y back to 0. Here's a strategy for helping you visualize how rotation works. Adjust the render window so that the x-axis lines up pointing at you, or out of the screen. Now, when you change the x value, you'll be rotating around that axis, and the shape will rotate like the hands of a clock. Like this. We'll move the shape around counterclockwise by changing the parameters. From 120 degrees to 195 degrees and 300 degrees. Now we'll reset X to 0 and let's point the Y axis towards you in the same way. Watch how the shape turns like the hands of a clock as we change the Y parameter. Okay, let's set our shape back to its default. For some design requirements, you'll need a rotation that is not around one of the three axes. In this case, we'll rotate our shape in stages. Let's drag our cube off the workspace and bring in a cylinder. We'll make it tall and thin, so it's easy to see. If we want to lay down this cylinder between the X and Y axes, we'll need multiple rotation blocks. Again, imagine your shape rotating like the hands of a clock, with the Y axis pointed directly to you. Lock the cylinder block inside the first rotate block and rotate it 90 degrees on the Y axis and render. Now our cylinder is lying on the X axis. How do you suppose we can get our cylinder to move halfway between the X and Y axes? Again, think of movements like clock hands, this time on the z-axis. Let's bring out another rotation block and nest it around the rotated cylinder. Now, if we rotate on the z-axis by 45 degrees and hit render, we have our cylinder right where we need it, in the xy plane, halfway between x and y. You can watch this skills video again, or to practice what you've just learned, launch BlocksCAD and start building.